Hey y'all, so tonight we're going to be talking about sports and business. Now, one of the major things we got to remember when we're looking at sports and business is they do operate almost exactly the same. Now, the main thing we can look at when we're talking about both of them is how they use their numbers. So, most businesses and most sports teams will use numbers to help them facilitate their growth, their improvement. And they're really going to use these dynamics of how they structure out their training, how they structure out development, how they create new systems. Everything when it comes down to the numbers, it's all about your operations. Same, that's both sides of it with your sports and your business. On your sports, your operations really come down to, okay, well, you're using your statistics to now improve your game. So when you look at your numbers, what can you do to tweak those numbers, make them perform better? And then you can have a better output when you're operating on the field, off the field, on the court, off the court. Look at a business, same exact thing, right? Your operating systems. How are we doing this? We want to make sure that we have strong operating systems for our business. Now, when we look at the overall schematics of it, we have a business can be broken down in so many different areas. We're not just, now, a lot of people will apply numbers to their sales or their revenue. But they don't apply it to the actual portion of the business that will probably matter the most, which is the people. Now, if you look at your individual statistics, this is how we would score individuals to now look at on a promotion level or just on, hey, well, what can we do to make sure we're getting the best performance out of them? You can score people in areas of HR, you can score them in areas of customer service, you can score them in areas of obviously sales, but then you can also use the other ends of it, like when you're scoring them on, this is going to be a little bit different, but you're going to score people on, let's say, a retail store or a product service. You're going to score how many people are visiting your website or in your store, and then how many of those people actually convert into customers. Now, on top of converting into customers, what is their per cap per customer? So knowing those numbers and using those numbers to now apply it to how are we looking to improve this? Okay, well, if we know why the customer is coming in the first place, what can we offer to now bring even more revenue in there? This is one of the things I could tell you I learned when I was doing combo commissions at Cineplex as a high school student. It was always the upsell. If somebody wanted just a popcorn or a drink, well, upsell them. Get it. If they got a Scene Points card, upsell them. It's going to cost them another $3.50, $4, and then they get a candy with it and they got a combo. And then the thing for us at that point in time is when we were upselling on those sales, we weren't just generating more revenue, but we were also on our personal incentive sides, we're getting some combo commissions out of it. So little things like that, how are you now building those dynamics that are now helping your customer? Because at the end of the day, when you're sitting for a 3-hour movie, a popcorn and a drink might not be enough for you. But you can also look at the other side of it. When you're looking at an employee and you're saying, hey, well, these are students for the most part, they're in college, they're in high school, they're doing their own little things. They want that little extra money. So if you give them a little bit of an incentive to say, hey, well, we're doing this for our commissions, like if you can sell this many combos, we will give you a commission at the end of it. Well, that's going to incentivize and motivate your team to really want to push more on those sales too. So really understanding how those numbers work, and you can always find who your best salespeople are and who you'd want to put on the floor at that point in time, especially when you're looking at combo commissions. If you know how many, who the top performer is when it comes down to combo commissions, you're going to want to sit there and put somebody like that on a busy weekend. If there is a busy weekend going and you know that, hey, we want to get as many combos out the door as possible just to get the revenue up, you want to be able to staff those people in those areas at that point in time. So that is definitely a way that we want to understand how the numbers are working. Same thing when you're looking at players on the field. You're going to look at these players, you're going to say, well, these guys have the best stats. You're not going to sit your top quarterback just because you didn't look at his numbers. You're going to look at his numbers and you're going to say, well, you know what? In fourth quarter positions, I have a specific running back that I can look at them and I know that if I give them the ball, they average 8 yards a carry. I only need 6 yards to get a touchdown at this point in time. Well, more like better than not, you're going to put that guy in the game. You're going to say, hey, let's give him the ball to get that carry. That's a perfect thing. You would sit there and look at a guy like a Marshawn Lynch. You want that guy in there at that point in time to really punch it in there at the end of the game. So things like that, you want to be able to run the two ends of the spectrum and understand how these numbers are building your business, how they're building not just that portion of it, but you're building your teams at that point in time. And that's where we look at it next. If we understand that our business is just a big, huge organization, then we can understand that our business can be broken down into teams. Now, this is where I love using the football reference when it comes down to business, because we can look at it in the essence of when you look at a football team, you have your offense, you have your defense, you have your special teams. So your special teams is broken down into your kickoff team, your kickoff return team, your punt return team, right? And then even when you go into your offense, you can break it down into skill positions, and then you got your linemen. Again, on the defensive side, you can go down to your skill positions and go into your linemen. So you're working with all these different skill sets and all these different talents. And but everybody has to now come together and play a role to now help the team develop. So things like this come into play. You have to understand, how does it work for my team? Well, okay, if you can manage to run a successful football team and be able to have all of that in your business, you are probably going to be able to run a pretty successful business at that point in time, because you know all the, you know that there are going to be different rules, different dynamics, and they're all going to have to come together for you to get that win. But everybody needs something different. So you're not going to train your linemen the same way you're going to train your defensive backs, because one, defensive backs are faster. Two, they're not going to sit there and be going in the trenches all. They're not going to be going in the trenches whatsoever, really, at that point in time. So you really want to be able to hone that one in and know what you're doing at that point in time. And that's really where you got to shift the dynamic of understanding, well, in a business, it's the same way, right? Your teams are, you know, you're going to have your sales teams, you're going to have your HR, you're going to have your customer service, you're going to have your upper management, middle management, lower management. You're going to have all these different areas of your business, and understanding that every single area of it is going to need something different. Well, that's going to be crucial in how you build your business. It's going to be those things that when you understand how those roles need to be played and how you need to train and develop those roles. Again, you're going to go back to the numbers. You're going to use your numbers to now fix everything you need to fix in those positions, but not just fix those things. You're now going to use it to influence those roles at the same time. Help people really grow in those roles and help themselves identify what they need to do to grow in those roles, because most people will tell you what they need to improve on just by looking at their own numbers themselves. But one of the major things I see in businesses is they don't actually break down into teams like that. Usually when you have solid teams and they work together and they know what they're building, they know what their core competencies are. You can have an HR team that has a bunch of different core competencies between individuals, but when they come together, they can really build that and they can really push forward. So understanding that that is a factor that has to come into play, and how are you working with those dynamics and building those dynamics in the business? Really and truly, you want to be able to now help your business grow by using those teams and making sure those teams in every different department is solid as a whole. And then when they have to now come together for the overall scheme of the business and the whole strategy that you're putting together to build your company, you really want to have that implemented, and you really want to be able to push forward, because that's going to be what's going to grow your business fast, but right. Right. So that's the one thing we got to understand, is if we know how to implement it the right way, right, it will grow everything faster, because it can just be a spring loaded effect. It's like that slingshot. You want to pull back a little bit just to get that rocket fire projectile moving forward. So when we can understand those are the things that we want to build on these areas, and really which roles are going to be the ones that you want to focus on. So that's another thing you guys got to understand, is what roles are you focusing on? Because if you can focus on the right roles, and you can get the people in the positions they need to be in, then you can grow the business a lot faster by understanding that the people that I have in those roles are the right people for that role. What this happens a lot in a lot of businesses, they use a seniority-based system and they use a not-so-reliable scorecard system for their business to put people in certain roles. And it ends up being the people that shouldn't be in those roles in the first place get the role, they abuse the role, or they're not competent enough for the role, or they're not prepped for the role the right way. And it ends up having a tower effect where the tower starts to fall. And when that tower starts to fall, the whole business will implode from just that one sector. And then you have to now not you might not just have to just fix the one area. I mean, you might have to fix multiple areas because of one crucial mistake like that. And it was just because it was an oversight, and it happens very often in larger enterprises. I see this very commonly. They have a lot of oversights where they start to lose and create more gap instead of bridge the gap in their company because they're not putting the right people in the right place. Now, that can be fixed if you know what scorecard system you're using and how you're going to implement that scorecard system, because then you're going to be able to promote the right way, and the people that should be in positions will be in positions, and the people that want to be in positions will follow that scorecard to get to those positions themselves. So they'll build up the skill sets they need to build to now improve themselves into those areas. So just understanding that in itself, that's another thing. And then we want to look at systems. How do we build the systems for our company? Now, this is where we have to be very finite and working with this, because systems will be one of those things that they have to be tailored not just to the department, they have to be tailored to the product or service, they have to be tailored to the people, they have to be tailored to the numbers. So you're using all of these things to create a very strong operating system that can be pushed forward. And what ends up happening is, this is another thing I see very often, is businesses don't update their systems, so they end up killing their business because their system's not updated. That is the worst thing you can do for yourself, is not updating your system and creating that problem. Now, what we really want to focus on is when we're creating operating systems, this is where the money's made for the most part, is through operating systems. Because when we look at the evaluation of a business, we're not looking at the evaluation on anything besides really the operating systems of how that business is running. Because if that business doesn't have a structured operating system, we can't say, hey, well, this is how our business runs, right? And this is how we know how to track the worth of it. If you can't have an operating system guidebook or just how is that business operating overall, there's no way to quantify what that business's value is. So when we look at that, we truly have to understand it doesn't come down to week revenue of what that business comes in. It comes down to, okay, well, what's the operating system? What's the plus or minus? What's the profit and loss? And then overall, what's the grosses that we're looking at? What's the net margins that we're looking at? And then if we were to take this operating system that they use and we were to put it in another location, can it be just as productive? These are things that we want to understand when we're looking at that area of it. And the same thing goes into sports. We will look at systems. If we take systems from one area of our game and we put it into another area of our game, will it produce similar results? We're not going to look for the exact same results, because we have to understand there will be needed for growth. But we have to look at similarities at this point in time. What are the similarities that can be created from this? And can we have similar results if we now look at expansion? Because that's one of the major things with business. When you get to a point, you might not want to just be a local business. You might want to expand. And if you can expand and truly run yourself across the board at that point in time, you know you're in the right spot. And if you can take your operating system and you can apply it in multiple different areas, this is what's going to help your business grow. Now, what'll happen is there will be need for improvement in these areas. There will be need for growth in these areas. And when you're building an operating system, it's not gonna be, hey, this operating system is a one-off. That operating system will have to change. And in some areas, this is one thing I have to give new businesses as a little bit of an oversight. You will fail at building your first operating system. You will fail at building your systems at first, but here's the thing. The more you fail, the faster you fail at that, the better it'll be in the long term. Because then what you're learning at that point is you're learning what's not working and what's not growing. And if you can understand what's not working and what's not growing, that will help you in the long term evaluate what you can do to work. And finding all of the information and getting the insight, the best thing that I've seen businesses do that are very, very successful is they create an operating system and they have review systems on it. So they will ask for reviews on how is this operating system working. Now, when you do something like that, You can't just review it from your own perspective of you're just looking at numbers. You have to review it from the people that are actually implementing it. They're going to be the most credible sources at that point in time. Now, there will be areas where sometimes people will exaggerate what happens in the operating system application. So you have to leave margin for error in those reviews, that sometimes based on who is applying it, you have to look at that as who is applying it. Now, you want to trust that your people are going to apply things to the best of their ability, but you have to understand that sometimes that doesn't work that way. And if you can understand that that doesn't work that way, then you can truly build your systems in the way that, okay, well, you know there is room for error, but what's the majority of the information that's coming out of it? Now, if you have a higher return on the answer being a negative response, you have to take that seriously. Now, even with the, if there's a minor area of negative response, that's where your small improvements have to come into play. So you have to look at both ends of it. Now, if you have large reviews that are coming in negative, you have to change a lot of the system. Now, if you have small areas that need to be improved, okay, well, great. You have a system that is functioning well, but there still needs to be room to improve it to make sure that it's oiled up as best it can be. Now, that is crucial to understand, that you need to now oil that machine very, very highly. And you have to make that thing run like a train, just dumping coal into it and have it go across the tracks. These are things we want to understand about business and sports, especially with sports. We do this a lot. We create systems of training systems. We create routines for athletes. And then when we're building these out, we're now creating them in a way that if we now take it and we transfer it over to another player, we'll get similar results, but based on actual, that person that's applying it will see that the results will change and fluctuate, but the generalized system that we're putting in place will yield a specific result that we aim for. And that's what you got to do when you're creating your systems, is you got to create a focal point of what you're looking to achieve with that system. If you don't know what you're looking to achieve with the system and you're just building it out, it will create a problem, because then your system is just a system that has no true objective, new goal. So you can't figure out what you're looking at. Okay, so that's one thing you guys want to really focus on at that point in time, is what is your system building? What is it doing? And how are you really developing that system? And what are you developing it for? So what's the focus of the system that you're developing? If you guys can do that and you guys can understand that, when you're, whether it be in sports, whether it be in business, that is truly what we're going to look at. Now, again, the biggest similarity between sports and business is the use of numbers. So the more we can use the numbers and understand how it applies to the people, how it applies to the business overall, this is how we're going to now be able to scale and truly will help your business grow. Okay, so I hope you guys got something from this. And until next time, we will get another video on this business dynamics and how we can build our business through the use of really stretching out and looking at sports dynamics and business dynamics and to create those team systems. So we will get into how we build those teams and what the things we can do to now develop those areas and those departments are. Okay, so until next time, guys, I hope you guys got something out of this. But this is Mark signing out. Cheers.